Dear students, today we will discuss some chapters of our book, class 10 mathematics book, chapter like chapter 1, that is GST, chapter 2, banking, chapter 3, shares and dividends. Some questions we will discuss. Let us discuss some questions like that. Question number 1 we have from chapter 1, that is goods and service tax. The question is, a shopkeeper buys a camera at a discount of 20%. From the wholesaler, the printed price of the camera is ₹1600. The shopkeeper sells to a consumer at the printed price. If the sale is intrastate, fine, and the rate of GST is 12%. Find the GST paid by the shopkeeper to the central government, GST received by the central government, GST received by state government, and the amount at which the consumer bought it. Since the printed price of the camera is ₹1600, however, the shopkeeper purchased at 20% discount, therefore cost price of this camera to the shopkeeper is equal to 1600 minus 20/100 into 1600 is equal to ₹1280. Therefore, GST paid by the shopkeeper while selling to the consumer is equal to the difference of price, that is 1600 minus 1280, that is equal to, it is ₹320. So GST, total amount of GST is equal to 12/100 into 320, that is equal to 37.80. So GST given to central government, first question we have, central government, that is equal to 38.40 by 2, 19.20. Second question we have, GST received by the central government. For that, first we will find out what is the amount of GST total received. Second bit, this is your first bit, amount of GST received. First to find out what is the amount of GST received. That is equal to 12% on the sale proceed, that is your ₹1600. So this is ₹192. Therefore, GST received by central government is equal to 192 by 2 is equal to ₹96. And GST by state government, third bit, that is equal to again ₹96, because it is equally shared, the total amount of GST equally divided by state and center. Then fourth with the total amount paid by the consumer. Since the cost price for consumer is ₹1600 plus amount of GST is ₹192, that is equal to total amount paid by the consumer is ₹1792. That complete question number 1 from GST. Now we'll take a question from chapter 2, that is from banking. A question from banking. Mr. Chaturvedi has a recurring deposit account in SBI for 4.5 years at 11% per annum simple interest. And he gets ₹1014.18.75 at the time of maturity. Find the monthly installment paid by him. So for that, let us take the monthly installment equal to rupees X. Therefore, the maturity value is equal to total time is given 4.5 years. That is equal to how many months? That is 54 months. Therefore, formula we have 54 into x plus 54 into 55 into x into rate is 11 by 2400. And by cancelling 969, this is 6400. Then again by cancelling by 5, it is 11580. We will be getting, this is 54x plus multiply this 99 into 11, you will be getting 1089x. By 80. So we have here we got 54x plus 1089x by 80 is equal to 101418.75, or you can omit this one by 100, so that, and this you simplify, you are getting by taking out LCM 4320 plus 1089 x by 80 is equal to 101418.75 by 100. This is by simplifying 4, 24, 25, and this upper one is your 5409x by 4 is equal to 1014 1875 by 5. So x is equal to, after cancelling by 5, we are getting this 2028 2028 375, and while multiplying you will be getting into, this is 4, this if you take here 2028375 into 4 by 5409, this is equal to 8113500 by 5409. So this is 15. So 1500 rupees is the monthly installment. We have the third problem. Let us discuss in the next class. Thank you.